I just came out in the barn, okay? And Foxy is due Saturday. Oh my God.
She might have been due Saturday, but she decided to do it last night. So we have, holy crap, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh my God. There is 7 of them and they are all doing good. All of them are the correct size. Like nobody's, oh my God. Nobody's skinny. Everybody looks good, nice and pink. Everybody's super warm. So I'm gonna cover them back up. But we got new babies.
We got new babies.
Here's Mama. She's definitely pulled a lot of hair out. Like she made a huge nest. There's tons of fur in it. She feels pretty empty. I'm sure she's sore. I'm sorry, Mama. She feels pretty empty. She's definitely not got her big belly no more. She had 7. 7 of them, guys. So she delivered a little early. They look fine, so maybe she bred the first time that I was unaware of, so that's a good thing. She must have bred that first day. Okay, I'm gonna check. I'm not getting in the room because I'm going to go in there. Babies in the room. Super cold, so I'm gonna try to make this quick. The whole reason that I even came out to the barn to talk to you and give you an update was to tell you that last night I sold Fred. Now I'm still selling Ghirardelli, I'm still selling the lion heads, but one of the ladies who commented on the ad for the lion heads had said, you know, do you have any other breed of rabbits? And I said, yeah, I have mini Rex. And she said, well, when you get some ready, I'm really looking for, you know, a male to put with 2 females that I have. I'm starting my own rabbitry. And I told you guys before, when I first got the mini Rex, this is not where the aim was, that I'm trading up as I go. Same way with my button quail. I got the button quail and I bred and traded up until I got the Caternix that I was looking for. So it's the exact same thing. These rabbits, these mini Rex, are really popular as pets around here. So I'm breeding them to sell them for that. And I had to step out of the way. And so I told her, I said, yeah, I absolutely will sell you this rabbit. She was very interested. She and I met. She was telling me about different breeds that she had. And she has New Zealand Whites, which are meat rabbits. So I told her that, and she's got two or three litters of them due this weekend. And I told her, I was like, our babies will be ready about the same time. If you'd like, I'll trade you a couple of mini Rex for a trio, an unrelated trio of the New Zealands. And she's like, absolutely. So I knew that I was making the right choice by getting rid of Ghirardelli, number one, because she won't breed. If this were the New Zealands or a meat rabbit, I would probably butcher her, to be honest. I would probably have butchered her. But because she's so small, it's like she's 3 pounds and she's fully grown. It's not really worth it. And I can actually make more money with her as a pet. So to sell as a pet rabbit. So that's what I'm doing. So I'm gonna sell her. And I sold Fred. So I'm only gonna keep 2 does, which would be Foxy and Willow, and the buck, which is Blackjack. And I will breed those and sell babies to make money. I will probably, there's a possibility I will keep a doe out of somebody's litter to, you know, give Willow a break, the little hoochie who can't stay out of her boyfriend's pen. Well, I guess he's her husband. We'll say he's her husband just to make it legitimate. They just believe in polygamy. So whenever, I will probably keep a doe from her because she is a better quality than Foxy. You might keep a doe from Foxy, I don't know. But I will replenish mine. But I'm gonna start breeding the New Zealand whites, and we will start butchering them, and I will finally have meat rabbits. So I was able to move forward. It's still not where I wanna be. I still wanna have standard Rex, and standard, or in the big Flemish Giants to crossbreed. It takes 3 generations to get the giant Rex. So I've still got a lot of work to do, but that's what this is all about. Progression, farming, changing, you know, building up, building forward. So as of the moment, that's what we're doing. So I'm excited to tell you we got new babies. It seems like once, you know, once I brought the rabbits in, once I brought the quail in, once that day that I came out here and I purged my barn and I redid everything, it was like I started from fresh and now I'm just having new life and, you know, progress every day. And so it makes me super happy. I really struggled over the summer. But I'm happy to say now that everything's looking up. Everything's working in my favor and in my order, the way I want it to go. It's not happening as fast as I would like it, but welcome to the homestead life. Nothing goes fast. This ain't no microwave. This is an oven. It's a crock pot. It's a slow cooker. So I am going to let mama and baby rest. Mama and babies, all 7 babies. And I'm going to go sell the other rabbits this afternoon. And then tomorrow I'm gonna try to make a video. And number one, of course, you know, show you the babies, because you know I love baby animals. I'll show you the babies. And then I'm also going to sit down with my seed catalog and we're gonna go over next year's garden. And I may actually, if it's not raining, which it's been raining off and on, if it's not raining or not like super cold, I may come out here and walk and show you the future garden. Love you guys. I'll see you later. Bye. So it looks like I must have moved them just in time. I'm glad I did that, because I would have been really upset if I just stepped in dog poop again. Oh my God, guys, my life. I removed the dog poop back out to the barn because I got so excited over the rabbits and I couldn't wait to tell John. I ran back in and totally forgot that I have to pick up food. I have to watch the ground. Winter likes to leave me surprises. But I totally forgot to get food for the rabbits inside. Oh, I'm such a goober.